Assalamu alaikum. Was the euphoria of South Africa's unprecedented action of bringing the Zionists to the dock for genocide dampened by last week's ICJ ruling? In my opinion, no. We can't allow it to. Being the optimist and positive we must be as an ummah, we got to be astute enough to realize the flaws, but look to the positives to move forward. Ghazans don't need a court judgment validating their genocide and ethnic cleansing. Albeit it was a good try, South Africa, but the ICJ outcome was always going to be rigged. South Africa's position is highly praiseworthy. Its foreign minister was quoted, "South Africa could not stand idly by and continue to observe the killing of thousands of Palestinians." So much for the Western and so-called Muslim rulers who are complicit in this crime. South Africa's actions were also both historic and significant. No one has ever had the political will and courage to take such an action. So let us start by looking at the positives, then analyze the genetic flaws of the ICJ, and then explore what could be an alternative to the ICJ. Firstly, the positives. Number one, dragging the Zionists to the dock for genocide was unprecedented, unparalleled, which in itself is a victory. Secondly, international community is finally actually admitting that the Zionists stand accused of committing genocide and have a case to answer. Number three, symbolic victory. For many, this was more symbolic. Expectations on anything being enforced were not realistic or even possible. Number four, global attention. The case gave further global attention, highlighting the genocide to the world, even though this has been live streamed from the onset. Number five, isolation of the Zionist criminals. The Zionists and their Western backers stand more isolated than ever before. Lastly, the West has once again demonstrated its moral, political, ethical, intellectual bankruptcy in ever trying to preach to the world humanity, justice, human rights, or the like. And this represents a massive vacuum, an opportunity to Islam and the Muslims. For me and many, justice, true ideological leadership, is only addressed by Islam, as Islam is neither secular nor is it just thoughts or morality. Rather, its comprehensive systems provide humanity, the international community, Palestine, what is so badly needed today: justice and leadership. Let us turn towards what I term as the genetic flaws of the ICJ. Naturally, the ICJ, the ICC, the United Nations, international law, have all shown themselves to be fundamentally flawed, genetically compromised, intrinsically inept, in layman's terms, absolutely useless. Why is that? Because they were conceived by the Western colonial states themselves as tools which would service their political agendas, ignored at will and abused when needed. How deeply the so-called instruments of justice have been colonized by the West and are exploited is demonstrated by brazen international law violations, the ICJ ruling, the UN vetoes, the flagrant violation of resolution upon resolution, and so forth. These institutions and criteria are clearly not fit for purpose and need replacing. The vulnerability of the ICJ to political pressure and the recognition that any order would be ignored by the Zionists and its Western backers is evident in its failure to require a ceasefire. Its rulings are all recommendations. None of them are mandatory or enforceable, as we have seen since its pronouncement. The Zionists have continued to murder thousands since and long signaled their intention to ignore any ruling of the ICJ. In fact, the ICJ decision will potentially embolden the Zionists even further. Last but not least, the ICJ itself was on trial, as much as, if not more, than the Zionists. For many, it has failed to deliver and demonstrate any meaningful justice. Finally, no ceasefire, despite the overwhelming evidence, far greater than in the case of Ukraine versus Russia. Yet Russia was unequivocally told to cease its military onslaught. And yet another green light by the ICJ in this instance, to continue killing, displacing, and starving, all demonstrate the abject absence of humanity amongst Western-sponsored institutions. So where does that leave us, and what are the actions for us? Number one, our work continues unabated. We do not despair. We do not become pessimistic by the ICJ judgment. Rather, we will continue standing up, speaking up for Palestine, and exposing the Western-sponsored Zionist genocide. Secondly, remain positive. Let us focus and see the positives, the wins in all circumstances, and remain optimistic in the promise of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, as the promise of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is true. Thirdly, be standard bearers, advocates of justice through the call of Islam. The world lacks justice, a system which is fit for humanity, institutions which are independent to challenge imperialist agendas. This is where the Muslims need to step in and raise the case for Islam as a solution to these flawed institutions, man-made ideologies and systems which have repeatedly been shown to be imperialist tools only.